and welcome to my next video. And today I'm in Warsaw. I've arrived early morning on Saturday and I'm here for the Warsaw Gallery Weekend, which is the biggest art event in this part of Europe, so in Central Europe. And this is a weekend traditionally taking place on the last weekend of summer. And this is when all of the galleries that are based in Warsaw are open and they organize special events, special private views, as well as talks. So I will try to take you with me as much as I can to show you this vibrant art scene here in Warsaw. When I lived in Poland about 10 years ago, there were maybe two galleries, commercial galleries based in Warsaw, and now there are over 20. So definitely a lot changed, and I haven't been properly visiting Warsaw in the last 10 years. Definitely not to see all of the commercial galleries that have opened here. So it's a fantastic opportunity for me to, in the period of 2 days, to see what's on at the moment, what's up and coming in this city as well as in this part of Europe. So I've got 2 days to see everything, at least as much as I can. So yeah, I'm excited and let's go. I've just been to a few galleries here in Warsaw. First I started at Zachęta, and it's an old gallery, one of the oldest in Warsaw. I've been there many times before and they got always really good exhibitions. This time they had a painting show dedicated to Polish painter Cybis, and also very interesting show related to a typical Polish or a communist type of furniture, which is called meblościanka. I'm not sure how to translate it into English, so I'll try to look it up and then I'll put it on the screen. After that, I walked to Fundacja Galerii Foksal, which is one of the most famous Polish commercial galleries. They show in international art fairs like Frieze Art Fair, Art Basel, and so on. I actually have never been to Fundacja Galerii Foksal in Warsaw. I only saw them at the Frieze. So it was really interesting to see how beautiful the building is. It's one of the old buildings, but it has been refurbished. And I think they've got about 3 or 4 floors. So, wow, it was beautiful experience. And the exhibition by Paweł Althammer, also really interesting. Then I went to, let me just check what is the name. Then I went to one of the new galleries called Esta. I'm saying new, I actually don't know how old it is, but I definitely know that when I lived in Poland about 10 years ago, it wasn't there. So yeah, it's a beautiful space again, really nicely refurbished and quite interesting exhibition, a much smaller gallery though. And then I walked a little bit again, about 10 minutes, and I found myself just outside of the Palace of Science and Culture, and I had to kind of look for a gallery in one of an old apartments. It's called Rodriguez Gallery. I'm not sure what's the kind of history behind the name. I'll look it up as well. And it's a stunning building, such a beautiful old block of flats. Gallery worth seeing, worth visiting, just to see this, one of older authentic Warsaw buildings. Now I'm going to go to Raster Gallery. I haven't been there before as well, but it's a very famous Polish gallery, so yeah. That I managed to actually bump into one of my friends that I know from London, and she told me that she would be going to a finissage of an exhibition at SW Zamek Ujazdowski, so probably I'll go there after as well.
Sometimes I feel so happy. Sometimes I feel so sad. Sometimes I feel so happy. But mostly you just make me mad. Baby, you just make me mad.
It's the next day now, it's Sunday, and yesterday I walked and walked and walked. I've been to maybe 10 galleries, I'm not sure, maybe a bit less, but I've learned that there are 29 galleries taking part in the Warsaw Gallery Weekend, and this year I think is the biggest amount of galleries in the history of this event, which is 10 years old. And this year, for the first time I think, galleries from different cities are also taking part in this event. I'm about to leave the hotel again to finish visiting the galleries. But before I do that, I thought I will show you the goodie bag. They gave me this VIP card, which gives me access to more events. And I think there is an opportunity also to use a special shuttle car. I haven't seen those yet. So we received a really nice catalog that lists all of the galleries. And as you can see, it's quite thick this year. So each gallery has got page, and there is a version in Polish and in English, so they trying to be quite international. And yesterday I went to a talk at again CSW Zamek Ujazdowski, and the talk was in English. It sounds like there is an interest of guests from abroad, and there is also a guide, a normal guide and VIP guide. So the difference between those two is that the VIP guide has got all of the VIP events listed. So, just an update for you. It's Monday and yesterday was the last day of Warsaw Gallery Weekend, but I thought I'll just give you a quick update and finish the vlog. So yesterday was really packed with events again. I started my day with CSW Zamek Ujazdowski. Ziolkowski is one of the most successful Polish artists at the moment. I saw his work at Venice Biennial in 2013, 5 years ago. He's been showing internationally. He is represented by Hauser and Vert in London. So, you know, that gives you an idea how successful he is at the moment. In the past, I think he was predominantly a painter. This show at CSW Zamek Ujazdowski was showing new work, and they are just a variety of different mediums, from painting through installation to ceramics. And next, after that, I went to BWA Warszawa, where I saw performance by Marta Ziolek. I didn't know what to expect, but many people told me, go to see Marta Ziolek because she's up-and-coming Polish performer. And in fact, she is a performer as well as choreographer, and she works with fashion. She mixes those different elements of fashion, music, pop culture, choreography and dance, as well as performance. So she joins all of these elements together in her performances.
His head was still pouring with blood.
So I was really surprised to see something different to what I'm usually used to see in terms of performance art. There was a lot nudity there, and that's not surprising. Well, you can always see a lot of nudity in performance art, but Marta Ziolek added something more to that, realizing a script, telling the story. So the story behind this performance, which the title is Fauda, which I think you could translate as a wrinkle, maybe. So that was a story of her meeting Caravaggio, the painter who also loved to mix popular culture with high art. And she used the most strange elements, like flying dildos. She also included one more performer. It was a male performer who was dancing a sort of a ballet dance. And after that, I went to see a few other galleries, which were a bit further away from the main kind of city center of Warsaw. They were still very close, but it was about like 30 minutes walk, so that wasn't a problem. It wasn't as pretty walk as in the city center, so I decided to hire a bike, which was a great decision. It was really easy to do. That way I saw, I think, 5 more galleries. I'll show you the footage from there as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and please subscribe to my channel. That will really help me a lot, and yeah, I'll hope to see you in the next video.